Can money buy happiness? Now, we've all heard the saying, so in theory, we should live that answer. But in reality, many of us are chasing the almighty dollar. Linda Mullins, Chief Wellness Officer of Luxury Executive Wellness, shares how that race can be for nothing if we don't have our own inner peace. After her experience of burnout, she realized her actions weren't congruent with her values, and that was an issue. Rather than find ways to fill the void, there's beauty in slowing down. So now Linda and her traveling team of wellness practitioners support executives to reach a higher level of well-being. That's right, they come to you. Choose your destination, because honestly, we know that travel's a big piece of this. We need to separate ourselves, allow ourselves that time to really slow down and integrate the goodness and the lesson so we can reach that level of inner peace. Linda and I talk about the self-love journey, living through fear, and getting to the root of our beliefs. As you listen, think about what parts of you could be softened and explored. How can you benefit from slowing down and being lifted up? Thank you for listening today and always. If you haven't already done so, please rate the podcast on Apple or Spotify. It's a simple way to support me and increases the likelihood of others finding through inspired eyes. And don't we all deserve more wellness in our lives? Enjoy the episode and remember, travel can heal. You're listening to Through Inspired Eyes. Hi, I'm Jackie Roby, CEO of Inspired Journey Consulting and your host today and always. I'm an international speaker, co-author of a best-selling book, and a solopreneur. Travel, mental wellness, diversity, and inclusion are the foundation of my life, my business, and this podcast. Celebrating our uniqueness is everything. Whether consulting on sales and marketing, curating training, or through private coaching, I help immersive wellness resorts sparkle. The travel industry has my heart. You spend your lives caring for others. But are you caring for yourself? By weaving in human design and mental wellness practices, I support hoteliers and travel designers to shine in their brilliance. In each episode, you'll be able to hear from guests that can support your wellness and healing journey. Through Inspired Eyes focuses on all aspects of wellness, embraces healing, and takes a deep dive into the travel industry. Parts of it that most of us overlook. Listen your way into better travel and a better you. Welcome to Through Inspired Eyes. So, all know how much I love social media, and a gift of the past few years, as well as I think as a solopreneur, is maximizing your networking online. And because of my time with the Wellness Tourism Association, today's guest found me. And I am so honored by that. And we have continued to connect in a variety of ways and stay close. The more I learn about what she does, I'm just so blown away. And I thought, we obviously need to talk about this here. So welcome to Linda Mullins, who is the Chief Wellness Officer of Luxury Executive Wellness. And she is a self-proclaimed wellpreneur, which I love.
Thank you so much, Jackie. I'm just so grateful to be here with you.
Oh, I'm really happy to have you here. Let's talk about inspiration. What inspired you to start your business?
Well, it was a personal experience. So in 2007, I quit a lucrative career. I went to a six-week immersive boot camp to reboot my health. So I paid an incredible amount of money with no plan afterwards, and it helped to transform my health and my wellness. I wasn't unhealthy. I was just clearly unhappy. So from that boot camp experience, I came home and I knew it could be done better with mental wellness infused with the other components that it had. So it started there from a burnout situation in corporate.
I love it. Let me ask you, because we've talked about burnout a few times and everyone has a different experience. Would you mind telling a few of the things that you went through for your burnout?
Sure. Yeah. And it kind of happened over a few years. I was with an incredible organization, actually, but the demands were very high. Almost every vertical in corporate these days is really not relegated to tech, although that's a big thing. Automotive, which is what I was in. I was traveling virtually 100% of the time. And I had all these great patterns and lifestyle habits and a healthy life always, pretty much. Yet when I started that, I wasn't managing those. After some time, I began self-medicating. So when I work 14-hour days and you're not at home and you're eating different food from you would normally eat, kind of my habits went by the wayside. So anyhow, for me, it was a culmination of a few years. And even though it was a great company, some things transpired in that organization that helped me get to that place. So I left the company and took a kind of a year sabbatical. Thought I was going to do many things. Then I went back to work. And then what ultimately happened was, no matter how good the position was or how much money I was earning, if you're not well inside, if you don't feel well, if you're not grounded, if you don't have peace, it really is true. Money can't buy you happiness, right? So I had always chased the dollar for much of my life. It was that culmination of those years of finally figuring out, you know what? I'm squandering my health. I wasn't unhealthy, but I was squandering my health and my youth in my 30s and 40s, early 40s. From that, I don't think I used the word burnout then. I certainly did not. I was spent, exhausted.
I've used that a lot.
And I don't speak those words over my life anymore. But those were the feelings of overwhelm and dissatisfaction and unhappiness at the root. So I wasn't dealing with the root most of my life. I self-medicated in several different ways. It was that self-medication that leads to that you're trying to fill a void, trying to fill a void, trying to fill a void. It's all the same void. So my psychologist say, and she was a psychologist then with our team, and she is now, your actions are not congruent with your values. We're living in a state of incongruency, then something's amiss. And it takes you a while to figure out, because we know this one mode of chasing things, or this one mode of this is how I survive, this is how I live, this is what's important to me. Like a conversation I had with her a few years ago in Encinitas, she said, well, you're chasing the money, yet you want a relationship and you want to be married. And because I believe the chasing the big careers and the 60-hour weeks and all that is going to bring me the security so that I can have everything controlled like I like, and then I'll be ready for a relationship. But the truth is, I'm doing that and prioritizing that and making that a god, right? Because a lot of us make things a god, whether it's even our health, right? We can work out of the gym 4 hours a day, and we're just so obsessed with that. Or I'm so obsessed with work and financial security that I believe that's going to be the answer to everything.
Linda, I feel like towards the end there, you were telling my story.
Oh. It might be a few people's story, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Chasing the almighty dollar and really wanting to have that security to be in control. I feel very comfortable there.
Yeah, that's right. Me too. And it's such a lie, though.
Yeah. It's true. So I love how you talked about, I really appreciate how you talk about getting to the root of things. How do you do that now in your business for your clients? Can you tell us what that looks like?
First of all, we talk to them extensively prior to them coming on board with us, right? It's not just a sign up for a retreat. We talk to them and find out not just their symptoms, but what their lifestyle is like. And then what are you going through? A current client right now has had severe depression for 3 years and she can't shake it. And her entire family has this severe depression. There are many mitigating factors around that and so much depth that a lot of people really don't deal with. For our clients, we make sure we dig in a little bit as much as they're willing to, because some people say they want to do the work and when they get there, aren't really willing. And that's okay too. Sometimes they just need a break and need the encouragement and the conversation from the naturopaths and the psychologists. we dig in as much as we can to talk and find out what's really going on. Are you getting sleep? Are you socially connected? Do you have proper nutrition and all that good stuff? So we find out what their habits are, and then we find out when they first experienced some of that stuff, what event might have happened surrounding that. And each of the mental health practitioners that are on the team have their own version of a confidential pre-retreat questionnaire related to the emotional and mental health piece. Mm-hmm. So we dig in before they get there, and then we have a team meeting on Zoom prior to the retreat to talk about each individual client and what is our 360 approach. There's a reason it's integrative wellness, integrative well-being. We have mental health covered. We've got the physical health covered, spiritual health covered, and physical fitness covered. So we've usually got a team of four people that are surrounding that guest to lift them up to a higher level of well-being, whatever that means to them, given their current circumstances.
Wow. Okay. That's amazing. As I'm thinking about these retreats, are they pre-planned, like you have the date and people are applying to be a part of it? Are you planning it around the people? What does it look like?
It's actually a combination of both. And more recently, we're doing literally bespoke well-being retreats where we do it completely around one person or a small group of people that are coming together. We will take a traveling team of wellness practitioners. And what I mean by practitioners, it's not just me, the wellpreneur, right? It's a naturopathic doctor, a lifestyle medicine doctor, and a mental health professional, whether they have the acronyms behind their name or not. I have a penchant for hiring healers. Mm. I seek them out. I vet them highly. I used to be a recruiter. When I find a healer, everybody knows about it. Mm. I think you might have known about some I sent you.
Oh, yeah.
They are healing people. They are in the business of healing, regardless of what their title is. And that's who I hire. And they affect change like nobody's business. The wellness practitioners will travel to the yacht. They'll travel to your villa. They will travel to your homestead or whatever property or resort that you prefer to be at. What's home to you? What's vacation to you? We'll travel there. And that looks a little bit different from the organized structured dates that are on the website. So we have both. And when we have tiny retreats, meaning let's just say under four people, we're happy to do those because, again, it's kind of like having 30 kids to one teacher, right? We've got just a small number of guests, which we get to affect real change with. And the program is similar, right? Because we include multiple sessions with the mental health professional. We include multiple individual sessions with a naturopath. We include multiple sessions of fitness, yoga, or meditation, or all of the above, a day, breathwork. Breathwork's now kind of replacing yoga.
That's so cool.
Thanks. we're having fun with it. It's about them getting healed and moving to another level and getting rid of some of the junk that they've harbored. I can tell you, it gets me so jazzed up when I talk to a client who's recently been in a retreat. I just spoke to a client that was at our Del Mar retreat, and she is transformed and she's still going through it. She's taking a sabbatical from one of the number one big tech companies in the world. Heinous schedules, usually, like many people, but it's a very demanding company. She unlocked trauma that had been there for 42 years. And when you think about routines, you're like, spa and happy. We deliver all that too at a great place and beautiful nature and great spas and all that's part of it. Yet we do some real work. I get jazzed up about that. Yes, unstuck trauma, right? Let's unstick some stuff because I had a boatload of it myself.
Yeah, fair. Same. That's incredible. So Linda, what's your why? Why are you doing this?
I want people to become the best version of themselves. I like having people reach their healthiest potential. There was mental illness in my family. My mom didn't raise me. She was a manic depressive. Let's put it this way. She was diagnosed as a manic depressive, which is very different from actually being one. So back then in the olden days, in the late 60s, studies have shown, and one of my psychologists, Halle Demavandi, she did her, what's the word when you get your doctorate?
PhD.
Yeah, but your, whatever the final thing is you have to do to get it, on the former mental health care system in the 50s and 60s. And so if you were Black, you got diagnosed with schizophrenia. Mm-hmm. And if you were white, you got diagnosed with manic depression. That's encapsulating something. There's a lot more information surrounding that. But that was the systemic kind of thing back in the 50s and 60s. And back when the husbands could admit their wives to mental health institutions, right? Without the rights to, for the wife to have them say so. That influenced my life. Now I'm a very strong overcomer, resilient of many, many, many things. Yet when I look back at, and I'm a writer, so when I was writing the last few years about root extraction, I think it's the first chapter of the next book. It's where did that root begin? Where did the root of myself, my belief, my mental health stability, any fears, any belief systems, where did that begin? And some people think it begins in the womb, and some people think it begins at birth, and it's certainly environmental. I think so much is environmental. And so with mental illness in my family, my dad being an alcoholic, abuse abounding for years everywhere, all kinds of abuse, all of that. And I guess there was an arrogance about me for decades that was kind of like, just buck up. It was tough love, right? Just buck up and get over it. Not everybody has that ability, whether I got that from my tough upbringing, which I probably did, and it served me well for a while to be that person with that attitude. The last 7 or 8 years, I can tell you, have transformed my thought life, which needs to happen with most of us. It's made me much more vulnerable, more compassion, because I lacked compassion. These last 7 or 9 years, they have transformed me, and I needed the edges to be buffed off. And so my why is, having overcome all that adversity, to help people deal with the root stuff that really is the beginning of their adversity, their unwellness, their dis-ease. And that's why mental health is such a big component of my why.
I'm so grateful for what you're doing. And I feel that very deeply myself as a trauma survivor, depressions I've been through, and during my own healing, uncovering wellness and healing travel and realizing the world needed to know about it. And how can I not have? That's why Inspired Journey Consulting even exists.
I love it. I'm so grateful that you created Inspired Journey, because it does heal at the root level.
100%. Well, you know, when you're a traveler that is going with intention, like when they're traveling with you, that's when this magic can happen.
And they have the freedom to actually just bear it all. And we encourage them to bear it all. What's magic to me is when a willing guest, desiring change, needing healing, comes, and then they meet with skilled, compassionate people that help them achieve that.
It's absolutely incredible.
Did you know that turnover can cost a hospitality business 33% of the employee's salary? Not only that, but this industry has a 31% turnover rate. That's 3 times higher than recommended. Think about this when you're choosing your next salesperson. Shouldn't your funds go towards success? I know that every inch of your wellness resort was designed with thought and intention to serve the guest and contribute to their healing. It's beautiful. Well, let's design your sales and marketing team with the same tender, loving care. Throughout my career, I've met thousands of sales professionals. Even the most talented and successful struggle to properly sell wellness travel. Why is that? It's because they don't fully understand it. Inspired Journey Consulting offers wellness travel, sales, and marketing training that's curated to your property. With our support, your team can reach new levels of prosperity. Rather than continually pay for turnover, why not invest in retention? Let's talk more about it. Visit inspiredjourneyconsulting.com and go to the training page under the services menu. Or simply follow the link in the show notes. Schedule a discovery call today.
If we've been stressed or working a lot, I know you've got a daughter, but whatever your life is, whether you're single, without children, or with family, whatever, it takes you second or third day to decompress it all.
Absolutely.
And if you're actually seeking to make some change and get to the root of some stuff, you've got some reflecting and relaxing to do. So the more that they can do that, and the feedback from the guests, the three-day clients are just like, wow, I can't believe how much we accomplished in this time. Some of the resounding is, I wish I had one more day. My encouragement now is, if they're really kind of pushing that, or really, this is all the time I have, this is your life we're talking about, take at least one more day to just sit and be and relax. Because most of the clients, as you can imagine, Jackie, are doers, type A, right? They want to get done, and we want drive-through wellness.
Oh my gosh, I love that, drive-through wellness.
We want drive-through everything. Drive-through, like, okay, and I was like that. I'm like, okay, let's get it done. Let's go. Giddy up. It's an EAP. Yeah, we have a benefit. So we can have six sessions with a counselor, right? It's in a lot of corporate benefits. And so I go in, I say, okay, this happened when I was three. This happened when I was four. Blah, 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 blah. I tell them everything that, okay, now let's begin to work on whatever's going on with me now, because I wanted it done in six sessions magically. And I thought I was good for like a decade, right? And then some other stuff happened. I'm like, wow. So it's a constant. Yeah, I love the name of your company, because it's a journey, and the journey does not end. It's still going, right?
There's always something to heal. It's actually a beautiful process, because it doesn't all have to be trauma or sadness. The tears can be an amazing release, that all of a sudden you found a love of yourself that you hadn't felt the day before.
That is so good. I'm 57 and I struggled for many years, because I forgive everybody else and I do for others and I love and I become compassionate. The last person on earth to love and be compassionate with was who?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. I'm going to come back, because I do want to talk about self-love a little more. But I have a question regarding the retreat experience. I got one more thing for you.
Sure.
How are you really working with the spirit part of mind, body, spirit?
Well, faith is a core component to well-being. Faith is a component, whether you're Oprah, Deepak Chopra, Tony Robbins, or Simon Sinek, faith is a component of well-being. And it's a big one. So I am a woman of faith. I'm a Christian. I pray for every client multiple times before they come, regardless of how we were all raised, if we claim a religion or we don't, because it's really not about religion. It's about connecting to that relationship. So when I'm praying for the guests, praying for them, praying for a word for them, I receive a word for them. And I write the word, because I'm a writer. I write the word and it flows like a little chapter probably. Then I give it to them when they get there. The thing that I love is every single time up to this point, it strikes them at their heart and resonates with them, whatever that word was that I got downloaded. So that's the first component, to make room for or open up their mind and heart, because a lot of people may have particular belief systems. They've kind of left their first love. They're not necessarily talking to their creator, tapping into their spiritual self. A lot of people neglect it. It really doesn't matter what you ascribe to. It's neglected a lot of the time, because other important, urgent stuff takes precedent every single day, if you allow it. We have a group meet and greet with all the team when they get there on Sundays. And I give them their word. They don't have to read it that moment. But some do, and I make them cry. I'm like, yes, I'm an Oprah. I make them cry. I make them cry. I just want to touch their heart. Then it opens up the mindset, opens up the channels to receive. Because from my practitioner's point of view, not mine, is they've got to be willing to receive the healing, the wellness. And that component is it. So then I offer, and I tell them very clearly what my belief is. And I'm not trying to convert anybody or even evangelize. This is where that base comes from. But if you want prayer, if you want to worship, if you want any of these things, these are available to you while you're here. If you want coaching in a particular way, because we talk about it a little bit before, depending on the client's willingness to talk about it.
It can definitely change when they arrive.
That's right. We make it available to them. And that's, if meditation is their thing, we make sure that they have meditation in their program. If breath work is their thing or yoga is their thing, and that's their, let's just say, religion, or that's their spiritual component, then we make sure that's a part of it. Mm. So whatever it is to them. But what I think from my viewpoint, if we just bring up this awareness that there's a creator or a spirit, it just kind of reminds them a little bit of maybe things that brought them joy before, or connectedness to that was when they were their happiest or whatever. And then we make room for it. We customize it to their desires and beliefs. Whether it's Jewish, Hindu, Buddhist, atheist, Christian, it's about tapping into something bigger than yourself.
Yes. So interesting as you started to talk about it, because I actually grew up learning about Catholicism and Judaism because that's what each of my parents were raised in. My grandmother taught us, living in the same household, to study everything and figure out what you choose. So organized religion for me isn't a fit, though I respect whoever believes what they believe. I study human design and am a certified professional reader there. They talk about source. And I love that because it does mean different things to different people. It could mean whatever God that is for you. It could mean universe, could mean tapping into something deeper. But I think oftentimes you mentioned that disconnect. I think not only are people getting disconnected because other things get in the way, but also it's almost like losing the presence, right? It's become routine. I say this prayer, it's routine. I do this thing, it's routine. I do Sunday, whatever. It's just something you do instead of something you feel.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right. It becomes rote. That's religion. Mm-hmm. Whereas, are you connecting to what's behind that? Who is behind that? It's really about relationship. Mm-hmm. We are a spirit. We live in a body and we have a mind. We're a spirit first. So if we neglect that part of ourselves, then it impacts everything else, not just the way that you look at things, which is critical when you're talking about mental health. It impacts the way we think, the way we see. Look at the world today. The world is driven on fear. Mm-hmm. We don't have that sense of well-being, that sense of peace, and that sense of well-being and peace, that sense, not our physicality, but that sense of well-being and peace. The studies show that people who aspire towards a relationship with their creator in some capacity, they have more peace, they have more joy, they have less fear. And so when you have that baseline, just like on Maslow's hierarchy of needs, when you have a baseline of, I have food and I have shelter and I have safety, I say this is the spiritual hierarchy of needs. When you have that baseline, you operate not from fear, but from a place or a sense that things are going to be okay.
Absolutely. And I think it's such a gift that you give each of your clients that word that came to you, that was given to you, that you received. It's so special. Now I'm sad I didn't ask for a word.
Oh my gosh, I was praying for you this morning and I didn't seek the word. I was just praying blessings over you. So sorry.
Well, thank you. I'll take it. We talk about self-love and this continual journey. Where do you see yourself on that scale right now?
Ooh, that's good. I won't cry. Sometimes I do.
Now I can be Oprah.
That's right. You can be Oprah. I would say I'm a 7 now. I have a ways to go.
What's the top number?
Well, I think probably 9.5. I'm working towards that with others and myself, but it really stems from myself. I guess I hope I reach 10. 9.5 is where I aspire to, Jackie. But I came from probably unknowingly 4 to a 7.5 over the last 3 or 4 years.
I mean, that is huge. That is huge. And honestly, who can say that they're even a seven? I think that 10 mark, those are moments.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why don't we live in that space?
I would like to. Yeah. And I'm so grateful for your time and everything that you're doing for people in this world and doing it in a luxury setting, which we love. What are the best ways to get in touch with you or to learn more about luxury executive wellness?
Well, they can call me directly, and I'm actually open to that. I miss talking to people on the phone and live in person, right? I'm a people person. So I really like a phone call. If it interests you at all, what we've talked about, call me 214-647-1191 is my Dallas office. And Luxury Executive Wellness is the website, luxuryexecutivewellness.com. We are same company or a subsidiary of Inspired Leadership Group. So you can go to either one, find us on Google. Do we even have to say W dot anymore?
I don't know.
I don't think so. luxuryexecutivewellness.com. And you can poke around on there, but just know everything's customizable. But I really like to talk to you. Pick up the phone. Don't be afraid to talk to us, because otherwise it's more transactional, right? Mm-hmm. Or it's not for me, or it's, I don't like that location, or it's too expensive. Great, we'll customize something. I invite those conversations. And I am a big LinkedIn fan. LinkedIn and direct to our website and a direct phone call to me.
Amazing. That is phenomenal. I'm going to put all of those details in the show notes. Linda, thank you again.
Thank you.
And until next time, stay inspired.